Welcome to the fourth edition of our special webinar, News is Undervalued, brought to you in association with ABP News. In the last 8 weeks of lockdown, if there was a genre that saw an unprecedented hike of up to 200%, it was the news. This was also the only genre that, despite so many challenges that came with lockdown, continued to offer you fresh content. Also, whatever little addicts has come in these times of lockdown, most of it went to the genre news. With all of this working for it, the topic we are exploring today is 2020, the year of news. And with us today is one of the senior most media experts of our industry, Mr. Sam Balsara, Chairman, Medicine World. Welcome to the show, Mr. Balsara.
My pleasure, Nazia. Good talking to you.
Sir, you just heard me. I mean, correct me if I was wrong. Is this not, last few months have worked in favor of news because this is the only genre which is creating fresh content. This is the genre which has seen maximum hike. However, as an expert, do you think this has converted in the revenue growth of the channels?
So, Nazia, it's true. I think we are living in unprecedented times. And I will soon be completing 50 years of working life, and I've never really seen times like this, when TV viewership has actually shot through the roof. You know, from an average weekly GRPs of 3,500 at an all India level, the first week of lockdown actually saw 34% jump to 4,800. In the seventh week, that is the latest week for which we have viewership figures, viewership has of course tapered down a bit to about 4,300, which is a loss of 10%, but it's still a 21% increase over pre-lockdown weeks. Now, most of this growth has actually come, as you rightly said, on account of news, but yes, also on account of movies. So in terms of news, as you rightly said, something even more dramatic has happened. Total news channels GRPs have moved up almost three times, from 300 GRPs to over 1,000. In the first week of lockdown, representing a dramatic threefold increase. But over these 7 weeks of lockdown, news channels have lost GRPs. They've lost about 400 GRPs, thus showing that this dramatic increase is going to be a little difficult to sustain. Nevertheless, still, in week 7, the last week for which we have data, news channels still show 2.5 times increase from the pre-lockdown era. And GRPs have still gone up from 300 to almost 700. Also, I think if you look a little deeper, it's significant that female viewership of news has gone up as much as total male viewership, in fact, a little higher. Also contributing to this increase in news viewership is a substantial increase in non-prime time viewership, which is actually a very good thing. So, news channels now have viewership throughout the day, and also this is not really restricted only to Hindi or English. You know, Tamil, Marathi, Bengali, Kannada have also shown actually very high increases. So the question is, why is this phenomenal growth in news channels not result of proportional revenue growth for channels? Now, the reality is that, you know, despite all the science of CPRP and reach and all of that, that agencies and advertisers may apply for buying TV time, ultimately you must realize that it's a marketplace. And in a marketplace, price is determined by overall demand and supply, and not necessarily that benchmarks that agencies and advertisers may come up with, or any inter-genre CPRP comparisons. So the harsh reality is that AdX, the name that we give to the advertising media market, collapsed in April to the extent of 75 to 85%. So this is an estimate, but I'm sure the reality is somewhere thereabout. So considering these two factors, that there is a collapse of AdX, and also that CPRP for news has been fairly strong, news, I would say, has not fared too badly, because in week one of lockdown, according to the records I saw of TAM, news lost only 1% compared to 17% that the total TV industry lost. And in the last week or the seventh week of lockdown, news channels lost 16% compared to 33% lost by the TV industry as a whole. So, you know, you could argue that news channels have lost only half of what the television industry has lost as a whole. So in a way, the market has recognized the performance of news television. Now, this was in terms of FCT. If you look at it in terms of value or rupees, in my estimate, news genre has lost about half of what other genres has lost. Now, when an industry collapses to the tune of 85%, I should think the major concern of individual channels should be to grab as much share as possible of AdX rather than protect benchmark rates. All other TV genres, you know, despite their increase in GRPs, though the increases are much more modest compared to the news genre, were in fact able to grab some share of the diminished pie. The reason I believe why news channels did not grab a higher share than what they actually did is because they thought, or many of them thought, that it would be more beneficial to protect the benchmark rate. Now, news channels and their salespeople may not agree with me, but in my view, this is fallacious, because as we have seen in television, rates can readily move up or down depending on the strength or weakness of the demand. So to answer your question, which you headlined in the poster that you put up, you know, for this webinar, will 2020 be the year of news genres? My answer would definitely be yes. And definitely in terms of viewership, because COVID-19, by all accounts, is not really going away in a way. And considering that it affects the lives and consumer behavior of an entire population, I think news will continue to have greater interest and therefore more eyeballs. However, how much of it will translate to advertising revenue will be dependent on how agile and flexible news channels will be and how much hunger they display in terms of they wanting to increase their share of a diminished advertising pie in value terms. Now, whilst it is too early to make a prediction on what the January-December 2020 ADEX will look like, it is pretty clear to me that the pie will be smaller than 2019, considering that Jan, Feb, March have already been fairly poor months, and there is a question mark on how much cricket we are going to see during the rest of the year.
But considering that news is something that we are going to see throughout the year, and eventually, I mean, sooner or later, the lockdown will get over, how much do you see the genre benefiting this year? If you can give me an estimate in terms of percentage, because GEC will also take some time to come out with fresh content. Similarly, cricket, I mean, it won't just start the next day. It'll also take...
So, as I just explained to you, Nazia, I think I have no doubt that in terms of viewership, they will benefit, and they will benefit substantially. However, how much of that viewership increase translates to ADEX or translates to advertising dollars, it's a function, I believe, of how malleable, flexible the news channels are and how much hunger they demonstrate for the advertising pie. Remember, the other genres are extremely aggressive and they are fighting for the same advertising rupees.
So, news has not shown aggression in past?
Well, I believe they are not as aggressive or they are not displaying as much hunger as the other genres are.
Okay. What exactly do you mean when you say they've not shown the same amount of hunger? They're not accommodative, they're not ready to shift their rates, they've not...
Absolutely. I think the other genres are willing to accommodate requests, they're willing to recognize that ADEX has collapsed, and therefore their desire is to, you know, capture a larger share of the restricted advertising pie that is available. And I believe news channels are not doing that. Maybe they have their reasons for not doing that. Maybe they are comforted by the fact that their viewership has gone up by twice. All this is in fact true. But, you know, as I mentioned, it's a marketplace after all. And if you want a share of it, you'll have to fight for it. It may not come automatically to you as it did in the past.
So another thing I want to understand from you is, if we do not talk only of COVID-19 days, news, for instance, in 2019 also was, it dominated in the sense there was Lok Sabha elections, there were so many state elections, and it is also more of a habit kind of a genre where people do watch it for some time. Where has it lacked? I mean, even then, were they lacking aggression? Is it fragmentation?
I think news as a genre, I don't have the figures readily available with me, but I think has been steadily growing. When I say growing, I mean growing in terms of share of ADEX.
But
the point is that it has grown in terms of ADEX disproportionately, even during the weeks of lockdown. Like if you take, I think, many of Madison clients, their usage of news during the lockdown period would be much higher than what their usage of news was pre-lockdown. But you know, when you get included in a plan, there are several considerations of reach, frequency, and whatnot. So I think it may not always be possible that because you have done, you know, the entire share of, you must be able to get 100% of the share. And don't forget, as I keep repeating, it's a marketplace. So your competitor is also battling for the same rupee. And if he is weaker and his, you know, viewership share has not gained so much, then he's going to discount his prices to negate your advantage.
So that's actually the next question I wanted to ask you. Is fragmentation a major issue with the news channels? Are they competing too much with each other?
Yes, I think fragmentation is a problem, I think. And the honest truth is, yes, there is one news channel too many, you know. For example, even in English, you know, where the viewership is minuscule, you know, we have as many as 12 channels, including two business channels. In many of the states, like in Andhra, we have 12 news channels. But I don't think the news channels themselves can do anything about this fragmentation, because after all, we live, you know, in a free country, and that too, where there is no shortage of entrepreneurial spirit, where, you know, many businessmen men feel that they can make a success of news channels. So you really are not in a position to control their increase. And of course, as is well known, the additional attraction of having a news channel as part of your empire or as a business proposition is not just the profit that it can generate, but also the political clout that it can give you, which may benefit you in other ways or benefit your other businesses. So many news channels, in fact, have started and survived not entirely
on ads,
because, you know, profit was the only motivation to start that channel.
That's actually a very fresh view that you have given to us. We have not had that view in last three webinars that we have conducted on the same subject. So now I already have questions coming from our viewers.
Nazia, can I just add one more
thing? Please, sir.
Since I've applied my mind to it, you know, the challenge or the opportunity for the news channels that I see in the coming months is that, you know, in lockdown week 7, they were at 700 GRPs. Now the challenge for them and the opportunity is how to retain this advantage and maintain 700 GRPs for the rest of the year. Now, whilst it may be difficult to do this, I believe it is not impossible, you know, given the uncertain environment and the need for government to take frequent major decisions affecting people's lives and then announcing them to the people. So I feel that content managers could perhaps, you know, apply their minds to do four things. One is they should offer varied content to appeal to different target groups, including perhaps, say, a children's bulletin, much like, say, the newspaper's NIE program, which they've been aggressively pushing for the last, I think, two decades or so. Yeah. kids, you know, shouldn't have to grow up on cartoons and kid shows alone. After all, you know, television could help wean them away from these into something more serious and information based. Also, I think news television could do a lot by adding softer human stories that are, you know, emerging daily in the country. And these, I believe, can actually be more interesting than the fiction that AGC channels put out. Also, I think news channels should carve out a strategy on how to maintain the increased viewership on non-prime time. Because remember, you know, WFH would continue in some way in many industries. And finally, my fourth suggestion is that they will have to find ways of retaining additional female viewership. Okay. So I wanted to leave the news channels with the thought that I'm sure they can themselves, being experts, they can come up with a lot more ideas. But I had these four thoughts, which I believe if they pursued would help them, you know, try and retain as much of the 700 GRPs going forward.
I'm sure each and every news channel is going to follow the advice that Mr. Balsara gives to them. No, nobody will take the risk of not following your advice. Sir, I have some questions coming up, and I'm not left with too much time. So I'll cut my questions short, and I'm going to take up at least two or three questions that viewers are sending to us. Mr. Shailesh Hegde has said, congratulations, sir, for completing 50 years of working life. Advertisers follow eyeballs. News channels viewership is at all-time high. However, some of the large agencies are negotiating for bonus FCT, value additions like sponsorships, L brands, Aston brands, when clients are already benefiting with lower CPTs and CPRPs during this time. What would be your advice to clients? Thanks, Shailesh Shegde and ABP News.
So Shailesh, I just spent considerable time explaining my point of view that news channels are not operating in a vacuum. Both advertisers and agencies have, you know, other genres who are also talking to them. And don't forget, if other genres are at a disadvantage compared in viewership terms, then they try to neutralize the advantage of the news channels by offering lower rates and therefore matching the CPRPs or negating the advantage of additional viewership of news channels. So you have to be alive to this fact. And that is why I said, whilst news will continue to benefit, how much of that benefit of ADEX they'll get will depend on how much hunger they display for getting a greater share of the advertising pie.
Sandeep Srivastav wants to know, given we heard that COVID-19 situation is not going to end soon, also news genre should also be able to hold on some of the viewership growth on a longer term. Would news genre be considered by planners in the league of reach builder rather than frequency booster? Which is the role it has been playing? This, of course, would depend on how accommodative they are on grabbing a higher share of the collapsed addicts.
So you see, this is of course a mathematical question on how much role news can play in reach building. I think the honest truth is that news has not been very good in, reach build-up, except maybe on certain events or on certain occasions. But I do feel that there is a greater awareness of news as a genre and its importance amongst agencies and advertisers. And I think news channels will benefit from this in the coming months. I think they have already benefited substantially during the lockdown period at the expense of the other genres. How much they continue to benefit, I repeat, will again depend not just on their own actions, but also on the actions of news channels versus the actions of other genres. Because after all, you know, agencies will get offers from various genres, and each genre will put their best foot forward at a time like this when the whole pie is shrinking.
So I think if you allow me, I can take one more question before we wrap up. We have 3 minutes left, because I also want to take up this issue of regional news channels. So Sandeep Sharma has asked, in view of the growth of in viewership of news channels, can we expect the brands to be willing to offer better rates and deals to regional news channels based on the improved numbers? So how are regional news channels performing? Because we have discussed
I think highlighted to you, several news channels are actually doing much better than Hindi news channels. I think
the regional ones.
You know, Marathi, Bengali, if I recall right, are showing pretty dramatic increases. And I think for quite some time, you know, regional news has been on media plans of many brands. And I think they'll continue to be so.
Is it also because, you know, regional gives you your the news of your immediate neighborhood, you know? We all want to know what is...
Correct. And therefore, they get high viewership.
Okay. But when PM speaks, you have to go back to the mainstream.
Yes, of course.
So we have 2 minutes remaining. Should I take one more question?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. So given the volatility of news viewership, news channels perhaps believe that there are heydays and that the sun will not shine forever. That's why they are in no mood to compromise on rates for now. So the challenge, which is to maintain high viewership, is beyond their control. So I would imagine it's very difficult to a competitive pricing policy. It would have to be dynamic. Would you agree?
Well, I think television pricing will always be dynamic. I have no doubt about that. But I don't quite accept, and I don't think news channels should accept, that viewership will decline. That's a given. Yes, it is true that from week 1 to week 7 of the lockdown period, from 1000 GRPs to 700 GRPs. But I think rather than taking it lying down that yes, therefore it is going to decline to 600 GRPs next week and 500 the week thereafter, I think news channels should take some aggressive, innovative, out-of-the-box steps of how to retain this habit, you know, if not a regular habit, at least a snacking habit. And I think it should be possible to retain some of these additional viewers and some additional time, because after all, you know, 7 weeks is also a fairly long time to form a habit about watching something.
I'm continuing to get a lot of questions, but we have already run out of time. Maybe we'll have another session with Mr. Balsara some other day to accommodate all the questions. I want to sum it up, and I want to, I can now conveniently, more confidently announce that this is going to be the year of news genre, because Mr. Sam Balsara has verified it and has repeated it. And when Mr. Balsara says it, it has to be the year of news genre. And only thing that the news genre has to do to ensure that it is it continues to lead this year is to be more aggressive and follow all the suggestions given by Mr. Balsara. Thank you all for joining us today for this session. Thank you, Mr. Balsara, for your expert advice and suggestions. I'm sure the entire genre is going to gain a lot out of it, not just your own clients. And before we sign off, we want to repeat that this special webinar on news genre is brought to you in association with ABP News. Thank you very much, Mr. Balsara, for joining us.
Thank you, Nadia. Good talking to you.
Same here, sir. It's always a pleasure speaking to you. Stay safe. Stay at home. Take care of yourself. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.